Mobile app users are notoriously fickle, and I should know because I am one. Hi everyone, my name is Sam and I am a senior product designer here at Appcues, and today I want to show you how you can use mobile in-app messaging to gain new users and keep them sticking around. There are several different types of mobile in-app messages that you can use, from modals to tooltips to banners, and they all serve different purposes. Today, I want to walk you through each one of them to show you how you can best use them in your app. The first type of in-app message that I want to talk about today is modals, or you may know them as pop-ups. These are messages that display in front of your app's interface. First, we've got standard modals. These are kind of your typical pop-up modal. These are probably the most versatile type of in-app message. You could use them for announcements, upsells, calls to action, or promotions. You can display them when users log back in, when they reach a screen for the first time, when they complete a task. There are tons of applications for standard modals. Next, let's look at full screen. One of my favorite uses for full screen modals is when I want to introduce users to my app. Before they even see my app's interface, I can use a full screen modal to welcome them to the app and to set expectations about what they're going to find within it. I can even turn this modal into a full screen carousel to show off all the unique features of my app. Next up, we've got cover sheets. These are kind of similar to full screen modals, but they leave just a little sliver of your app showing underneath. I like to use these for release notes or major feature announcements. These are ideal for users that have already been to your app, they've already onboarded, and you want to show them all the ways that you're improving your app experience. And then there's the half screen modal, which is really great if you want your users to interact with it. It's really good for this because it's positioned in the lower part of the screen, closer to your users' thumbs. I like to use them for ratings, surveys, feedback, anything like that where I expect the user to take some kind of action within my modal. Be sure to check out our video on mobile surveys if you wanted more tips and tricks on how to use surveys to improve your app adoption. Now, if you want to be really subtle, you could use a slide out. A slide out can pop in from any side of the screen that you want. It's really nice for tips and tricks or quick thumbs up, thumbs down kind of surveys. Of course, you can use these modals for a variety of use cases, but some general rules of thumb are: one, use them sparingly. Save them only for the most important communications with your users. Two, make them match your app. Users nowadays are really good at tuning out ads or anything that doesn't look like it belongs. And so you want to make sure your messaging matches the look and feel of your app. You want to use fonts, colors, and imagery that blends in and is on brand. Three, keep it simple. Keep the copy clear and concise and make the calls to action drive directly at the action that you want users to take. Number four, be nice to your users. Make sure that there's an obvious way to dismiss a message if users do not wish to see it. Because you know how frustrating it is when you go to look for that dismiss button and you can't find it. It's either hidden or not there at all. Don't make your users hate your app. Now let's talk about tooltips. Tooltips are a great way of introducing features and onboarding users, and they're a lot less disruptive than modals. The best part about tooltips is you can actually show your users around the application, rather than simply relying on imagery or text to convey the message. A really good tooltip onboarding flow will highlight the essential features of the app in about 3 to 7 steps. Make sure to keep the copy short and let the app's features do the talking. And finally today, let's talk about embeds, or inline content. The advantage of using embedded messages over modals and tooltips is that users can continue to use the app while the message is on the screen. There's no need to interrupt the user's current task or risk them missing your message because they dismissed it too quickly. You can instead let them engage with the content when they're ready to. The two general types of inline or embedded content that I'll focus on are banners and cards. Banners typically sit at the top or bottom of the screen, sitting just above or below the navigation elements. They usually take up the full width of the screen and are great for things like announcing service outages. If part of your app isn't working for some reason, or if servers are down, you can keep your users' trust by informing them as soon as possible. You can also use banners for promotions, webinar announcements, important updates, and so much more. Cards, on the other hand, can accomplish pretty much anything that modals or tooltips can. It's just all about where you put them. They can be used to encourage feature adoption, conversion, soliciting feedback, driving upsells, and so much more, just all about what you say and where you put it. As usual, just keep the copy simple and direct and make sure the message looks like it belongs. So these are the main types of messages that can help you gain and retain users. If you're interested in adding these messages to your app without taking up precious developer time, check out Appcues Mobile. You can get started in minutes and publish your first in-app message in just a few clicks. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more great product content from Appcues.